getting to wrap up this week, you know, the semester. So it's just loose ends and stuff like that. I'm really looking forward to having some time off. I mean, relatively speaking, time off. There's always something to do, but yeah, I'm going to wrap up the semester this week. You guys doing good? You had a good weekend? What'd you say?
You look a little heavy today.
Oh, that ain't good. I mean, unless you mean heavy, like weight-wise, because I'm trying to gain weight, you know? Oh, man.
No. I think we need to do your rose and thorn. What's going on with you? What was your thorn? Now that you, well, what's your rose? You don't tell us the thorn.
The thorn. Are we live?
Yep.
Always live.
This is not a side conversation. We live.
You know, the thorn probably, not necessarily a thorn, you know, just the consistent grind of getting things done, being responsible, staying on task with things that I need to get done. I guess Rose, maybe I finished a project that I have been working on, a part of a project I have been working on. So it was a nice relief.
Give yourself with the applause button. Hit the applause button.
Hey, how do I sound tonight? I got a new tour. I got a different microphone. How do I sound? Everything sound good?
Sounds good to me, but you know, they talk about my laptop, so I really don't count.
We're going to get you hooked up real soon, Shauna. Real soon. Y'all good? Did y'all already do your rose and your thorn?
No, I'm going to. TK, I just want to know, are you going to fix your call or are you going to just sit halfway?
I actually did it on purpose. So you got to always know the meaning of this. Always. Okay. Believe that everything that TK do is strategic.
I know, man, but I'll just tell you, one side was down, so I wasn't sure if you were trying to flash us or not.
No, that's letting you know it's after hours and TK is starting to get
cute, sis. You're
you know cute. What I'm saying? I was all trying to be tied up. No, we're just going to go ahead and let the tie loose.
That's right. You cute.
You see what I'm saying?
So, can you tell us your rose and thorn? How are you today, my love?
Good. I don't even think I have a thorn today. Is it like just for today, or you mean like thorn as in what you're going through? But as of today, no thorn.
Let's do today. Small, what's the word I'm looking for? Small wins. Let's do today.
Small wins. Very productive. I always love a productive day. I start my morning out with what I'm going to do. I literally live off of my calendar. So everything has to be on my calendar. And then each morning I create a checklist of things that I need to do today. Okay. And everything got a check mark and very productive.
So. Well, I love when my to-do list gets checked off.
Absolutely.
Well, I had, my day didn't start out good, but I got to tell y'all off air, honey. I can't tell the word of my business.
Ryan.
My day did not start off too good. I'm so mad at myself. And when I tell y'all why, my husband told me to be hard on myself, but it didn't go too well. But it's not unrepairable. I got time to fix it. But the good thing is, and my rose is, I can fix it. So it's not a bad thing. A part of my thorn is, you know what I'm dealing with, TK. And
I want to hear Ryan's opinion off the air. Because I really do. Off the air, Ryan, okay?
We're going to leave everybody else hanging like that. Now they're all like, what's going on?
I know, because those are the two things that's really like been my thing today. But today was a good day. I was very productive today. I pressed 20 shirts today. I'm getting ready for a pop-up shop on Friday. I'm going to be singing at a Juneteenth event. So I'm just preparing myself for the week. So I'm excited. I'm glad to be back. I missed y'all. A week feels like it's so far away. But all right, let's get it started. Everyone, again, I am the Dr. Shonda Roberts, and
what is Ryan looking at? Look at him, Shonda.
I saw him, but I wasn't going to say nothing. He's probably fixing this up. Leave him alone. I am the Dr. Shonda Roberts, and just in case you don't know, the whole month of June is my birthday. I'm still accepting dinner dates. I have a dinner date tonight at 9 o'clock. So I would not be hanging out with y'all past 9:01 tonight. We're going to get this show finished, hopefully on time.
Did she ask me, Ryan? Yes,
I have plans tonight. So I just want to let you all know. And this is the 13th day of the month. So you all have exactly probably 2 more weeks to fill me in your schedule.
I love this girl.
Y'all are ready. The 25th is booked.
The 25th is booked. That was my day. I had something for you on the 25th, but it's booked. We can't do nothing.
So, you're going to find another day. So I just want to thank you all for joining us again. I'm going to pass it over to the queen over here. Want to be half naked on the show today. Good evening.
Just because I got my neck showing, oh, really? you know my mama is watching. Mama,
I loosened up, man. It's appropriate.
You know what I'm saying? Thank you, Ryan. First of all, wait until November. Ryan, when is your birthday?
July 24th, 1 month from the 24th of this month.
What? We got you. So you're next. You're next. Mm-hmm. Okay.
All month, by the way. All month.
That's right, Ryan. That's right.
Okay, well, I do the whole year since y'all want to take up the whole month. Just just the rest of the end of the year, okay? Yeah. Just celebrating me. Hi, everybody. I am TK Owens. What a great show that we have for you. Another night, we are going to the corner with Dr. Shonda as your host tonight. But let's go ahead and introduce to the guy down below. Guys, Cindy is still in Dubai being a Disney princess. So, Cindy, we love you. We miss you. We can't wait to see you when you return the end of this month. But Ryan, passing it down to you.
Thank you so much, TK. Yes, we miss Cindy. We look for her to be back. Good to be with you ladies this evening. Ryan David, psychology professor at Miami-Dade College, holistic and leadership lifestyle coach. Man, glad to be here, man. It's really interesting doing this on a Monday because I do a lot of my content creating on the end of the week, you know, on Fridays and Saturdays and Sundays. But to start your week off with something like this where you're interacting and stuff, I'm settled into this. So glad to be here. Hello, everybody in the chat. Shout out to everybody in the chat for joining us again this evening.
Yes, so I am so excited. I'm so excited, so excited. I think we may last a little longer, but I'm gonna try to get through it. So tonight, I have a couple of friends that have been in my life for a few years now. They're my little brother and sister, but also TK knows them as well. They went viral a while ago, years ago, matter of fact. I think it was 2013, if I'm not mistaken. And I was, you know, we always talked about them going viral. I said, well, let me just get them on the show and get their views of what happened. I know there were some, you know, not so happy things and happy things about going viral. So why not talk about it? Everybody wants to go viral, but they're not equipped to know what comes with going viral. It's not always good. It's not always bad. So we're going to welcome Mr. and Mrs. Adrian and Brittany Bell. Hey y'all.
What up, Sid?
How you doing?
I'm good. I'm good. We're doing good.
Hi, Brittany.
Hi.
Brittany, what I mess with it. She's tired.
No, I'm with TK over there.
Thank you, Brittany. Hi, Brittany.
Listen, TK cuts up. Don't let her fool you. TK cuts up over here.
Look at Ryan's face.
Hi, Ryan.
Hello, everyone. Hello. Thank you, man. I appreciate you. I got to get something straight. Y'all were making fun of me because I'm looking off screen here. I'm trying to get my live right. I got my YouTube over, my Facebook over. I'm trying to get it right. They say I'm flirting with somebody in the chat. I'm just trying
I'm
just trying to get my stuff situated here. Nothing extracurricular going on. Welcome, y'all. Welcome to the show.
Appreciate it.
Y'all got some fans in the chat. Everyone, thank you all for tuning in. Let us know where you're tuning in from. Also, make sure you share this live. Give us some hearts and some likes and some shares. Invite people to tune in.
That's we right. are going I to just realized I wasn't live on Facebook, Shonda. Sorry. Public. Let me go public.
You wasn't live. That's fine. Yeah, sorry, I was going to tell you earlier, but I thought maybe you had done it already since we do this every Monday. But I didn't want to put you out there.
The shade is real.
The shade.
Oh, she gets real extra when she hosts.
True. It's true.
She gets real extra when she hosts, honey, because she is fabulous. It's June. Honey, y'all ain't ready for me. So let's just get right into it. Brittany and Adrian, welcome to the show again. Thank you all so much.
Thanks for having
me. So you all went viral. It was June 13th, 2013, correct?
Today, 9 years ago.
Yes. So today, 9 years ago, Adrian proposed to Brittany. How ironic it fell on this day.
Yes. I said, how ironic that this happened today, and this was literally 9 years ago today.
Exactly. I have a little clip. But listen, my editing skills are not what Miss TK Owens can do, but I try to do a little something. No, she's good with editing, so I'm not. That wasn't even shade. That was shade on me. I just put two videos together and ended it with no, you know, nothing. So that may not look too cute, but y'all get the idea.
Thanks. Let's do your thing.
So, Brittany, I have your proposal video up. Well, Adrian, I have your proposal video up. Set us up. Let us know what happened that day. And so, what did you expect? What did you think was you were doing?
Well, I'll go because you did it.
Go ahead.
So
we went.
That was our off day. I'll never forget. We went to the beach. And we went to some new soul food restaurant up in the city area. So when we got back, my grandma actually went out of town. My grandma, if you know me and you follow, you know I talk about my grandparents, but my grandma went to Georgia and she was just coming back in town. We were supposed to be going to the movie, so I thought. So everybody was supposed to be meeting up to go to the movie. So I said, well, I'm gonna go change so that we can get ready for the movies, but I'm gonna see my grandma first. So he was like, okay, cool. But then he was stalling. Now, one of my friends, if I would have been thinking more, she kind of was hinting something was going on, and to me, she said something that should have triggered it, but it went over my head. So when we pulled up at my grandma's house and everybody was outside, I'm like, you know, as you probably can hear, what y'all doing here?
Right, right. So that's why I wanted you to set it up, because people are gonna see other people in the background. They don't.
Right.
You had no idea what was going on.
I had no idea, because if I would have known, I would not have been wearing my little cover up beach dress. I would have been clean. Like, I would at least, I'd be like, why y'all didn't give me something? Like, my friend should have been like, well, why don't you put something on since we're going to the movies? But the way it happened, everything happened how it's supposed to happen, because I had no idea. So,
okay, now, Adrian,
ma'am,
how did you get her to not know what's going on? What did you do that day?
I was stalling as much as I possibly could. I had everybody, it was a lot of texting going on.
In which I didn't even pay that
she attention. She didn't pay no attention because I like to text. I don't really like talking to people too much, but right. I like to text. So I'm communicating to everybody, sending all these messages out, trying to get everybody to the house. And I had one of my friends, he's a DJ. He went by, set everything up, set all the music up, and a bunch of family, bunch of friends came by. And soon as we pulled up, it was just, I mean, we didn't block the street. I didn't block the street off intentionally like that. Yeah. It just happened to happen like that.
And no cars came on the street.
No cars came. If they did, nobody was paying attention to what was, you know, to where the cars was coming from and nothing like that. So it just worked out perfectly, and the rest is history.
And the crazy part is that street is a busy street.
It is.
It's a very busy street. So my grandma, she said your mom was here and watching over to make sure nobody came, because it's always cars on that street. So
I'm gonna play the little we have a minute clip. So I'm gonna play that and then we'll come back to it.
Go ahead.
A minute.
Go
ahead.
Speak out and interrupt this ceremony. Oh, baby, yeah. Just say, all you gotta do is say,
love me.
Say that you love me, and we will walk. Yeah.
all girls do like this when they get engaged.
I know. But what people may not know that Adrian is a mimes as one of his professions. He does 100%. Yes. But one of his professions, he mimes, and he's an awesome, awesome. Was it mimer? I don't want to say it right. What do they call it?
That works.
Okay. And so he chose to use that to propose to Brittany, and I thought it was beautiful. You have to go to their YouTube page to see the full video, because I promise you it'll have you in tears. Now,
the gloves make a little more sense now that I know that. The gloves make a little more sense.
Yeah. I meant to say it before. It was part of the setup, but I went too fast. So that being said, that video got 2.2 million views. That was one video I saw.
Yeah, that was just one. Yeah. The most we totaled up was 79 million views.
And all over the place. That one video got two.
Yeah.
And I don't even know how many videos are out there. We see it all the time.
Yeah.
So what was, give us your experiences. Well, let's start with the good stuff first. What were the good things you got out of the going viral?
I mean, it was just, for me personally, I feel that it was able to be a light that, you know, love still exists, you know, Black love still exists, and that everything don't have to be toxic. You don't have to go through the bad to have something good, you know. And then I felt that for me, being plus size, it was able to show other women, like, you can, you don't have to be, you know, the skinny girl to get somebody that genuinely loves you.
Right.
So my position on it came from different aspects, from me being plus size to me being confident to us being, you know, two young Black male and female, you know, a couple that is, you know, just genuinely love each other with no strings attached.
Right.
And I think that, you know, in our society, you know, everybody go by, you know, different things. So we were just something that was different. And I feel that, you know, Adrian's the one who, he took it up a notch when it came to proposals. And
yeah, they started calling him Mr. Proposal.
Right.
Yes.
Other people started, you know, it started getting better and better as the years go by. So I don't know. That was my good on it.
For me, it wasn't my intention to go viral.
Right.
I think a lot of this day and age with stuff that gets put up online, there's intentionality for it to actually go there. Mm-hmm. But it was literally me just being me, wanting to express how I felt about this woman, and just propose a way, like the only way I felt I knew how to do it. And I had never seen it done before, so it made so much sense to me. But it wasn't like, I'm gonna post this and this thing about to blow up. That was never my intention. I just wanted to do it the way that I wanted to. And it was just received well. It came with a lot of, you know, some negative. Of course, the negative comes with the positive. The intentionality was love, just to show the love that we have.
That's awesome. And if people don't know, they did eventually get married. They've been married now how many years now?
This year makes 8 years.
8 years. Congratulations.
Congratulations.
I was reading the comments. A lot of people said, I want to follow up with this couple. I wonder what happened. And I saw a lot of the negative stuff. And you know, we be having y'all back, honey, because I was commenting back to them people. Listen, go on.
y'all know Shonda gonna comment.
That was years ago, TK. That was years ago. I don't do that no more. Okay?
Today?
That was not a comment. That was a review. That's different. So, Adrian, can you all share with us what were, you don't have to go too deep in it because we want to stay positive, but what were some of the negative? I want people to see the pros and cons.
I'm going deep. I'm going to be honest with y'all. Adrian never looked at the comments. He only knew about something because I told him. Right. He like, I don't care.
Smart dude. Don't
we know what it is. Yes, he like, well, you know what it is. I don't want to look at it. I don't care. And then like it was, and the thing that's so bad, and I tell people all the time that it's so sad to me how we as people, no matter what race, color, nothing, nothing. It can be 1,000 positive, but that one negative
can overshadow.
And it was like, oh, you know, she big. He using her. You know, that comment for me was just like the worst. It made me cringe. Mm. And then like it was another comment somebody made in reference to him being sorry and just like he looked like he ain't got no job. He not gonna take care of his master. And even though like I know my husband's the hardest working man I know, but it's just the fact that even though I know it's not true, you know, at the end of the day we always say, oh, words don't hurt. Yes, they do. You know, and it's just like so crazy how I, at that moment, allow people who didn't even know us to put their opinions on me and to like mess up such a beautiful moment. And so I had to like talk to myself, like, these people don't know you, how I'm miserable. And it's like, why are you worried, you know, letting somebody up, like I said, who don't even know us to have that much control over my own energy. I was in my late 20s, so yeah. I didn't give up a lot from then. You know, just something so nice, so sweet. Everybody's not gonna want the best from you, for you, you know. So I had to, you know, realize that and take the good. And it was so many. I mean, we barely on YouTube, and we have nearly 20,000 followers, and people just want to know. And it's like, at first, I'm like, I don't want to keep in my business, but it's like, sometimes, you know, you have to be that example and that light. And if God wants us to be that, I'm okay with that, because I know with him, we ain't going to go wrong, you know? So
I was going to say, I know a lot of time as women, we are, I know our men, our husbands are protectors. Ooh, we are protectors as well.
Yeah.
You can talk about Shonda all day, but don't talk about my husband.
Talk about my husband. Don't talk
you about your husband. Baby, the wind coming off.
From zero to
I get too upset. Do not make him mad. And don't talk about my husband. That's me what you want, but leave him alone. Because he may not. I'm going to say something.
Yeah.
I'm going to say something, and I'm probably do something. Right. I've been saved a little bit. So I still have potential and tendencies to go back to Rainbow City. But my husband. Come on.
Right. See, and your husband just commenting too.
TK, you on mute, baby.
They go.
I can't TK at all. Can't you
hear you. Mute.
I'm on mute. Yeah, I had Ryan, take Shonda Mike away. Just take the whole.
She good, man. She good. She's speaking facts, telling the truth.
And she knows she feel the same. I don't know why she had it, because she was knocked somebody down by Farrah Owens.
What? You talk about my husband, my mama, or my kids. It's all right.
It's
all right.
It's a wrap.
Ryan, you have anything you want to ask?
I was just thinking, listening to what their experience was about, and she's right about the perception and how the negatives far outweigh the positives. The reason why is because, just from a psychological standpoint, you know, that's what I do, is we're threat sensitive. We're sensitive to threat. And so that's why the media preys on us the way they do, with negative news and not positive news. Positive news is good for a minute, but negative news, it'll sit with us. It'll weigh on us.
Yeah.
So that's the reason why those negative comments, they just stay with us. And it doesn't matter, like, say, it'd be 100 to 1, but just that one, if you get in your head, then you're worried about perception. And it just, you start to play with your own mind and what is somebody thinking. And like, man, like he said, man, if they ain't paying the bills, man, they don't know me. They're not really relevant, but it's hard to do.
Right. Yeah. But you know, when we did, when we first started our TikTok, we went viral on TikTok when I surprised him last year to go to Dubai. And we had like 500,000 views. And no, I didn't see any negative comments. And I said, now he did propose for me, and it was this and that. Now I do something for him, and they like, oh, you the GOAT, you this, you that. It's like nobody was giving that negative energy. Yeah. It was a totally different perspective as a woman. And you know, some stuff can be real. They like to compare, you know, the men versus women thing a lot. I know this, so
It's 8 years.
Go ahead, Adrian. I'm sorry.
It's 8 years later on top of that. So a lot of people know the story for the most part, and bought into it. So and they see that it's genuine. Like I don't, it's not no game, it's not no front. I celebrate her as much as I can on Facebook. Facebook is like the mountaintops to me. So I scream how much I love this lady on Facebook as much as I can. And I think that it's just, people can see that it's genuine. And once they see that, then, I mean, what else can you say? You can hate all you want, but it's not like,
I was gonna add to that. In today's day and age, you have so much stuff out there that's not genuine. It's staged. It's fake. Yep. It's for the likes. It's for the followers. Yep. And then when you have someone like you guys, a couple like y'all, you do something that's genuine. The skeptics and the haters are out there assuming or thinking, oh, y'all are fronting. You're pretending. You're trying. No, man, it's genuine, man. Just fall back and relax and enjoy it. It's not. It's for real.
Right.
Yeah.
People who are happy for other people, they'll never not enjoy.
That's right. It's coming from miserable people. Yeah. That's exactly it.
When good things happen to people around me, like I'd be excited and happy because it's just good to see. It's like it's so much going on in the world. Why not want to see somebody else flourishing and happy and where they are in life? You know, life is hard to everybody. We all have problems, you know.
How many viral videos that we see, and I go through the comments. A lot of times it's funny. I mean, I look at funny stuff, but a lot of times you go through these comments and people, it's fake, it's not real. But who just like it and keep it moving or don't like it? Ain't nobody asked you to analyze the video. Right. And they go through and they take it apart and they pull it apart. See, they take screenshots.
They got too much time on their hands.
That's right. Why you got to remember how much energy and effort and time it takes to
do
all that. Exactly. So if they're commenting and leaving comments and they're hating and they're doing all these things, like you said, it's coming from a place of misery and suffering from themselves. They're spending time on this. It says a lot about what they're doing and who they are in the first place.
Right. The day and time that we are in now, so many people are hurting and they're looking at social media and they need to see genuine love. There are a lot of people that want someone to genuinely love them and care for them. Mm-hmm. And seeing stuff like that gives them hope. But then you have people who are miserable because they can't get themselves together to find somebody who's going to love them. Right. So they get on social media and pick apart everything they can see.
Right.
I'm sorry. I thought something was crawling on my head. I'm about to shut the
You know, my mom taught me, and I made sure that I also pass it down to my kids. If you don't have anything nice to say, just don't say it at all. Yeah. And especially a beautiful moment like an engagement proposal. That is about love. It's representing love. Who in the world can go in and say anything?
Cowards.
Exactly. And Adrian, you are a very smart man because I have a say-so. You are in control of what you receive.
Yeah.
You not reading those comments? Because Brittany, I'm gonna be honest. Once you take it in, it stays there.
It stays there.
I can remember that one negative. I can still remember something somebody said to me in my childhood because it stays with you.
Yeah.
So I've even learned and I teach people when somebody is texting you, our argument is two people. Yeah. You can't argue by yourself.
Right.
So learn how to not respond or find the appropriate time to say what you need to say. But when I see someone going off on me, I choose to block, delete, and remove you.
Mm-hmm.
I promise you I will remove you off my chat.
Right.
It's hard, but when you guys go viral and have the amount of followers that you have, you can't control everyone.
Yeah.
But Brittany, I do want to say to you, because you did bring this up, and I just love empowering women. Your weight, because you mentioned it at the beginning, that has nothing to do with it. You are beautiful, young lady. Do you understand me?
Absolutely.
That man loves you. It has nothing to do with your weight. I don't want to ever hear you say, because I'm a big woman. Honey, you are a woman that man fell in love with.
Come on, evangelist.
I just love
TK. I can support the weight. You hear me? I'll be in the gym. I can support the weight.
Yeah. And
the thing with social media to support what you're saying is the thing with social media so much is about the aesthetic. It is about what we see. It's about the visual. And so we get so caught up on what it looks like, we forget there's so much more to it than that, especially with a couple. It's ridiculous.
Yeah.
I appreciate y'all so much for coming on. Do y'all want to stay on to join our next topic?
Yeah, go ahead.
All right.
So thank you all so much. We're gonna wrap it up because, as I said, I have a date and I got time to play with y'all today. So we are going to move.
You actually froze.
You froze up, Sean.
I'm trying to keep talking through it. My screen is frozen, but I'm gonna keep talking.
My God.
Next we're gonna go to Miss TK Owens. Can you? But I'm sorry, TK. You know I'm always out of pocket. Let me find it. Where you at, TK? I got my glasses.
And I better get a sing. I better get a jingle. You better sing for me. Yes.
TK's moments. TK's motivational moments.
Okay.
You heard it, Ryan?
Okay, okay. Cindy, we miss you, but we got a little stum over here.
Yeah, a little bit. Thank you, Dr. Shonda. When I think about what I'm going to talk about every Monday, I also try to tie it into what the topics are about. And one thing, the second topic, which we will get into that, is how much you love yourself, or just even self-love, because the way that you love yourself is exactly how you could teach others how to love you. And that's a quote that I found today. And this is so important to me. One thing about it, I love myself way too much, and this is not being conceited or cocky, but I just know my worth. I know what I stand for. I know what Linda Pratt, which is my mother, I know who she raised. And so when someone says certain words to me to try to bring me down, I literally can laugh at them because I know who I am. At the same token, I do know that I'm not perfect. I know the things that I would love to work on, but love, you can't love anyone else. And Ryan, I would love to hear from you after I finish. To me, the way that you love yourself, the amount of respect that you have for yourself, would teach others just how much you need to be loved and how they need to love you. We actually did a segment on the different love languages. So teach the person, if they don't know it by now or know you by now, teach them what's important to you.
Right.
Okay. Do you love gifts, or are you the type of person that love, you know, your touchy feely? Teach the person how to love you. And first of all, before you can love anyone else, make sure that you love yourself. Ryan, from a psychological standpoint, I would love to hear from you about self-love.
You just stole it. I mean, you really did. That's really a lesson that I teach when I talk about, you can't do anything for anybody else until you can do it for yourself. I say this so often, and it's really one of my philosophies in life. You can't care for, love, trust, respect, support, provide for anybody else until you can do it for yourself. And so when you talk about self-love, I think, TK, the way to say this, and I know exactly what you mean, and you're spot on with how important it is. The way to say this is self-love. When you say, I love myself, just so that we don't sound narcissistic and people don't spin this, when we say self-love, we mean self-care.
Yeah.
I care about myself.
I care about me.
I care about myself. I invest in myself. I support myself. I matter to me. And so what I say is self-love really equals self-care. And the thing about it is you have to be able to know who you are so that you know what you love before you can help anyone else understand how to love you. And I don't want to get too far into this because I know
Ryan to do that at the end.
Yeah, we're just going around, and I got something that I'll talk about when my segment, Shonda, when you throw it back. But really it has to do with knowing yourself. And then once you know what that is and how you like to be loved, then it comes down to communication and working with them and letting them know. But your quote is spot on, TK, 100%.
Awesome. And so, guys, from my mouth to God's ears, I will always and love to share with you our motivational moments on Monday. So back to you, Shonda.
Thank you, TK's motivational moment.
get it, Adrian.
TK's motivational moment.
Oh, TK's motivational moment. I like that. I want to hear Ryan's.
You need a jingle, man.
I'm gonna, like, I think of something before Ryan's come up. Okay,
nah, so we good.
I love y'all, and this may be the day I lose my job because I do not know what's gonna happen when I open these cards. So I hope TK don't fire me. So
what we got there? What is this?
I know.
Oh, no, TK.
I'm completely.
I don't like surprises.
So this is not a surprise. I told her.
She said, "Let's play a game." Actually, she did say that. Let's play a game.
She did, but she's not. That's what's inside, right?
Because I don't know. I want to open it.
All right, I'm listening.
I want to open it with y'all. I have been seeing these. I don't want to give them free advertisement, but I have been seeing these on social media forever. And I bought relationship debates that I'm supposed to take on our couples trip, but I forgot. And then they have self-love, the self-love deck. And I think it was important because a lot of people aren't loving themselves these days. They're going through so much, and people that, like me, I'm always taking care of everybody else. Sometimes I forget to love. I mean, I love me. Don't get me wrong. But I can't take time for me and take an hour out of the day for me and do something that, you know, I want to do. That's why I'm very making sure that I am celebrated this month. I got 13 more days available. Who won't take me out?
Oh, Lord.
So I bought this self-love deck, and I want to play with y'all. Y'all ready?
How we doing? Let's go.
And I tell you, I'm just opening it. So I kind of opened it while TK was talking, so I won't put my nail. Take much time.
So what's your topic? There it is.
So
I'm helping you tonight.
How do you love yourself, and how do you... I don't even know what I'm supposed to be doing.
Teach others how to love.
Thank you, Ryan. Thank you.
How to teach others to love you. So let's do this. So this is supposed to be a game with people in the room, but since y'all not here, I'm going to shuffle the deck. And I'm going
to give parts to that, right, Shauna? That's two parts to that. That question is two parts. I mean, keep in mind, this is two different things. But
right. We're going to answer the second part after we play the game.
All right.
And that's where you're going to come in at, because I know you're going to teach us that.
Mm-hmm. We're going to school. Ryan always taking us to school.
Always. So this is now it says self-love, but it has different topics, right? It says your stake in the game, who hurt me, stand for your standards. So I guess that will be the how you teach people how to love you. Line in the sand, teach people how to love you. Smile, onward, leap of faith. So I'm going to pick a card, and I'm going to ask somebody to... one of y'all to answer.
What are every game has rules, Shonda? What are the rules for the game?
Is she right? Because I didn't hear one.
Y'all not with me. Look, the rules are on here, but we ain't got time because I'm gonna go. We ain't got time for that tonight. I'm just gonna read these cards, and y'all gonna answer the question.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay. Yeah, the rules are just when you're
she's making up her own rules.
Yes, she is. All right, questions. Let's go. Questions.
Ryan, they called you John B.
They call me whatever they want. They don't pay my bill.
They call you John B.
I mess
with John B.
Everybody is in love with Ryan. I get it all the time.
I've been called for many things.
Somebody said when Ryan started talking, they just can't breathe.
Listen. Wait, my mama told me to put Ryan on the show.
Sorry, TK. Go ahead with the question, Sean. I know you gotta go.
Wait, my mommy is on here. Hi, mommy. I don't know who she's talking about. She put hello, sister. Hey, my Adrian, that's your friend.
Yeah. Enjoy. Get down.
That's an inside joke, y'all. I'm sorry. Okay, let's start. It's 8:37. Honey, I'm hungry. Okay, TK. I'm gonna come to you first. We are going to Forgiveness University.
Oh, nice.
What mistake have you yet to forgive yourself for and why?
Wow, like that on air live?
Yes.
Okay, wait. Repeat the question.
I'm glad I didn't get that one.
Okay, wait. One more time. Repeat the question.
Okay.
You can have that
one. What mistake have you yet to forgive yourself for and why? I got one for you.
Chill, just chill.
Oh God, don't put me on a timer. I gotta think about this.
Really, you still beat yourself up for TK?
You want me to come back to you, TK?
No, we ain't coming back to it right now. Hot minute.
Let's go. I got plans. Because
I don't want to say my children are a mistake.
Let's come back to her. Whoa.
Right. But I mean,
Daria not watching.
No, I hope my kid is not watching. But what I mean by that is I became such a young mother at 22 that I literally put my career on hold for the sake of my children. But I don't look at it as a mistake, but I'm trying.
Regret, I think was the word, right? Regret. You haven't forgiven yourself?
I don't even regret because I have two beautiful children, but I wonder sometimes, Shonda, if I would have ever took that route, I would have been on ESPN. So that's right.
I made it better, sis.
That's right.
So, but instead of me being on ESPN, I created my own podcast and talk show. So there it is.
Oh, that's right. You're gonna be on ESPN, NFL Network. Boom.
You better claim it. Okay.
Okay. So that was good. Everybody gonna get two questions. We got time tonight.
Okay.
Okay. Ryan.
Uh oh.
I'm about to not answer the question like TK just did. So whatever you got to
ask. John B.
Go ahead.
The Eligible Bachelor.
Uh oh.
The if women. You could marry yourself today, what vows would you commit to keeping?
Ooh, look at all the women. They just got quiet.
I don't even understand the question. All of them. What do you mean?
Oh, Lord. Okay, so then tell us which ones then.
Oh, you want to know what the vows would be?
Yes. Yes. It says, if you could marry yourself today, what vows would you commit to keeping?
Marrying myself, and I have vows. I promise to be myself, stay myself, and always love myself till I die.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
The day I die.
Okay. Perfect.
Good enough?
You think too much.
I'm marrying myself now.
You're talking to a logical person.
Yeah, I know. I gotta give something different. Never mind.
What would you say? What was you expecting? Maybe I didn't understand the question.
No. You did right. I just want to give you something harder next time.
If I was marrying myself.
Look, all the women just took notes.
Which I would love to do, by the way. No.
You heard him. He want to marry himself. I hope y'all caught that. Just ladies, playing. There's no
I'm going to give this next one to Brittany because we talk about friendship a lot.
Okay.
What five qualities must a person possess to become a close friend of yours?
Communication. Mm-hmm. Communication should be all five, but communication. Right.
Big fan. Get some applause right there.
Communication is my main thing.
Huge.
I can't really say five. It's really communication because time, we older, so it's like, you know, but to me, it's if you can't communicate, we can't be friends.
Right.
You can be cool and all, but communication would be big for me because I've been put in positions where I feel that my friendships have, you know, been a problem because people don't communicate. Mm-hmm. You know, it's communication to everybody else except the person is a problem for me.
Okay.
Out to the person.
So. I'll take that. And I want to also tell our viewing audience, you answer these questions as well in the comments and let us see how you answer these questions.
Yeah, do that. Let's see what you guys
can do.
We'll read some of your answers on here. Okay, Mr. Bell. I got all cards in front of me so I can see what I want to ask you.
Oh, God.
Adrian, if you could write a letter to the childhood you, what would it say?
Oh, it's a great one.
Mm-hmm. Ooh, that was a good one.
It's a heavy one, though.
Yeah. I almost took some stuff, but I ain't asking no questions.
It's a long letter, too.
The short version. Yeah. Of course.
45.
Stay focused and have tunnel vision.
Okay.
Nice.
Yeah. Okay. Can you elaborate on why?
Of course. Okay. I've allowed myself to go through a lot of things in life. And that's just being associated with certain people. But it's like made some decision or hung around with certain crowds that I think delayed.
Getting distracted.
Yeah, getting distracted for sure. It definitely delayed where I want to go and where I'm going. My focus changed from what I wanted when I was in high school to what my friends wanted, and I kind of latched on to what everybody else was doing, the dreams that everybody else had, and I tried to put mine so far back on the back burner that I turned them into what theirs were.
Forgot who you were. Yeah.
After everybody separated, went their own ways, I was stuck, left with without a passion for what I was doing.
Right.
And I feel that if I would have stayed focused on my passion and my goal from Jump Street, then I definitely would have gotten there a whole lot quicker. I believe that God would have gotten me there a whole lot quicker.
Awesome. Mm. Thank you so much.
Great focus, man.
So
pull one for you, Shonda. Hello.
Okay, exactly. She thinks she...
Okay.
Like, okay, good.
I wasn't going to do it, but I think this one like slapped me in the face. So
yeah.
It says, why do you love yourself? And I feel I love myself. What, TK?
It's not like the easiest one. That's why she made that.
Exactly.
Yeah. Okay, I'm going to find something.
You cheated.
She cheated.
Wow. Okay. This one says.
Answer that one too, though, Shonda. I know you got something real quick. Why you love yourself?
Yeah, why do you love yourself?
I love myself because I have overcame a whole lot. Amen. I have grown a whole lot. And there are a lot of people who probably won't be on this earth anymore had I not did the work. When I left out of the situation I was in, I was very angry. I was very miserable. Work, school, friends, nobody could get near me. And everybody, no one was exempt. And I feel that I have grown a lot, but also in my growth, it has caused me to be hurt because I was trying to not be the mean person anymore to where it allowed me to be hurt. So then I had to rearrange how I thought and how I accepted people in my life. And things that I did and how I moved. So now I know how to protect my heart to not be the mean person, but protect my heart and still be strong at the same time. So that's why I love myself, because nice. I grow up.
You should, as you should.
Right. So I had a good one. What did I do with yours, TK?
Oh, no. But you didn't answer your second question, but okay.
What was the second one? I forgot where I put it. Describe. No, that's not it. That wasn't it. Oh, here it is right here. If you could erase a hurt that you caused another, wow.
Jesus.
That's your question. Exactly. She said, I'm not going to tell my business.
This game.
So I'm going to give y'all this. If y'all can answer, we answer. Because I only got to think about it. If you
need the box. The box part said this game is not to be played on live TV.
Exactly.
We have to be vulnerable to people to know how to heal. Yes, it is.
Okay.
If you could erase a hurt that you caused another, which person would you choose and which pain would you take away?
Do you count?
Yeah.
Yourself
counts.
That's selfish, but I'm trying to think of who.
Me too. Why we can't talk about the hurt they gave me?
Right.
Why I got to take my hurt back?
This forgiveness university is by you and what you could do for the universe.
Right. It's like how you could, because you're healing yourself by saying, I'm sorry to somebody else. So who did you hurt? Well, you got to say who. Let's not say who. We don't want to tell all our business. Who did you hurt and choose which pain you would take away?
But I agree with you. The first person for me would be myself. And nobody hurt me more than I hurt myself by accepting and allowing something I should have stopped or put it, you know. So I would definitely say myself first.
That's good. I didn't say you could say yourself. That's perfectly fine. I agree with that. I accept a lot of stuff.
Like they said, what they did to us, that's what it is.
Because if I hurt them, they probably deserved it.
Okay, Ryan. TK, I'm coming back around to you, sis. You ready?
Okay.
Probably deserved this savagery.
Savage. Because one thing about a Scorpio, we will sting.
My God.
Sorry.
Okay. What would you like? Oh, Lord, I'm moving my car. What would you like?
Your face.
The last. Okay. What would you like? This is deep.
Oh,
ready?
Lord.
What would you like the last chapter in your book of life to be entitled?
Jesus Christ.
That's deep.
Lord.
I actually already.
We talking about how you're crying around here. When you're
Okay.
Last chapter, TK, no matter when it is.
What is your last chapter and it says entitled. What is your book of life to be entitled?
Lord will, a long time from now, but what's the last chapter called?
Yeah, long time, Lord. Take it right now. I need another lunch date.
The legacy fulfilled.
Okay, yes.
Hey, that's how you're going out, all right?
That's how I'm going out. I literally said this the other day. There's only one more thing I want to do in this life before I leave this earth. But I have lived a great life. If I was to leave this earth tomorrow, I have accomplished a lot that I set myself out to be, and I have no reason. I had a great childhood. I had a great adulthood. I've just done a lot, and I'm just so grateful for the journey. But there is one more thing that I want to do that is on my goal list, that is a long-term goal of mine. And I want to accomplish that before I leave this earth. And I actually can say, I want God to say a job well done. Mm. And so it will be a fulfillment. So the legacy will be fulfilled. And that will be the title.
Mm. Okay, so all my single ladies, pay attention. I'm going to ask Ryan.
Ladies, take your notes, ladies.
Good Lord. Hey, Shonda, real quick. Upon reflecting a little bit about my last question, what I realized was I'm already married to myself. And if you ain't already married to yourself, you need to propose like my man Adrian did ASAP. Oh,
yeah. In the mirror.
Ryan loves himself. Do you understand? Ryan loves himself.
Let's go.
Lord, he loves himself.
Had plenty of time to do it. I know that.
My single ladies to take. What is the other lady that couldn't breathe and he was talking? Okay, so Ryan, you ready?
Go ahead, brother? I'm ready. Born ready.
What's your idea of the perfect date? Take yourself out on the date you just imagined.
Ladies.
They trying to get you something.
Where's Casey? Where's Casey when we need her?
Right. This is the perfect night for Casey.
You're asking me what the perfect date would be if a woman was going to take me out?
Yes. What's the perfect, what's your idea of a perfect date?
You want a PG version?
No.
What are we doing here?
We need Look at Adrian.
What are we doing?
Look at Kimberly. Look at Kimberly.
What are we doing?
Wait, look at
the
eyes.
What are we doing here?
Look at the eyes.
So I'm going to tell you up until like 10 o'clock, the date.
Wait, say it again?
I'm going to tell you about the date up, the ideal date up until about like 10 o'clock.
Elaborate, sir.
Oh, man.
You want double answers for days. Don't short answer us tonight.
You know what? A lot of conversation, no matter what we do, let's just put that out there. Whatever we're doing, we need to be able to talk. I don't want a lot of noise, a lot of distraction. I don't want a lot of hoopla. Like, if perfect date for me is I'm connecting with you. We're talking. We're getting to know each other. We're laughing. We're having a good time. We're getting deep intellectually. So somewhere we could spend time, like, talking. I like to do a lot of things that are maybe a little more unorthodox. I'm not really a high maintenance or, you know, spend a lot of money, big events. You know, we could just go. We could do something simple. We could stay at the crib, cook at the house. We could go something small, like spend time on the beach. I mean, it's not
10 o'clock.
There's so many options, you know, as far as like simple things to do. I think it's really about how we spend the time, not so much what we do. So that's all I have to do for now.
That's good.
I hope y'all got y'all pen to paper. Okay. You like 10 o'clock dates.
No. The day start before 10, but I was only going to tell you about what I want to do up until 10.
Okay.
It ain't longer than that.
All right, Brittany, I'm going to try to give you not a so deep one.
Okay.
I don't know, because I like when you think deep.
Oh.
Okay. Where are you going? Okay. What's something you do that you don't thank yourself enough for?
Something I do that I
don't thank yourself enough for. I can name one.
Hey.
I don't know. Because when you do stuff from the heart, I feel like I don't, you know.
But it's something you do for yourself that you don't thank yourself enough for.
Like an ability, a strength, something you do for yourself, something you provide for yourself that you don't really, you don't really appreciate the fact that you're doing that for yourself. You invest in yourself and it's worth something. It's important. Give her a clue, Sean. You say you know something.
Yeah, what you know? I don't know. I take care. I believe in self care.
You do. She just finished her master's degree.
Oh, so yeah.
Give herself enough props. But what she had to go through.
That'd be hard. There you go. That's a big deal, too.
People go to work. They are entrepreneurs. She did a lot. And she got her master's degree. And she did it with flying colors. And I'm so proud of her. So I want to know, you to know that I'm so proud of you doing that. Even in the midst of the pain you had to go through. Yeah. Even working a full-time job and having an entrepreneur, having your own business. You did it, sis. So.
You're right. And see stuff like that. I didn't even think of that. And that was very that was a lot. So
there you go.
All right. Okay. Age, are you ready?
Nope.
Exactly.
You can't be ready for these questions. Nope.
Right.
Nope.
This is the last one for Adrian. And then Ryan, you're gonna wrap it up.
All right.
Okay. So Adrian, you lift weights and stuff, right?
Yes.
For the next 30 seconds, it don't matter. For the next 30 seconds, pretend your words are arms. What words would you use to hug yourself?
Pretend
your words.
My words are arms.
Uh-huh. What words would you use to hug yourself? yourself?
I think they're saying it's a metaphor, like symbolically speaking, what would you say to yourself that would make yourself feel hugged, feel loved? Like, you, what words would you use? I don't know what the weights had to do with that. He might hurt himself.
His arms, hug yourself. You make yourself strong. You hug yourself. That's why. Right. I don't know. It made sense to me.
Hug yourself with words, Adrian.
Yeah. It's encouraging yourself.
Uh-oh. Yeah. Jesus loves me.
Hey.
That's right.
Anything that I can literally put my mind to, you can do. Don't be fearful. Don't hesitate. Focus. Continue to keep God first and let him have his way in your life.
There you go. Ooh. It's like an affirmation. You know, it's something that you're talking to yourself. Yeah.
That's a silent preacher right there. Right? That's a silent preacher.
Now, Shonda, can I say something right quick before you go to your question? Just to tie in what Adrian just said, I saw a quote yesterday that said, the strongest prayer is when someone can say, God, let it be your will.
Yeah.
And, and not mine. Because that you're trusting whatever he do. It takes a lot for someone to say that.
Yeah.
So listen, y'all, real quick. I opened up the relationship. Call me, ask one question.
Why she only get one question?
When we get together, it's gonna be real spicy, Brit.
Relationships.
Okay, listen.
Okay, what relationship?
We're gonna let y'all go, but I got stuff to do. You and anybody can answer. It don't matter. You and your significant other. This is the relationship deck now. You and your significant other are drinking one night and talk about the first time you met. They admit they were really interested in your best friend that night. How do you respond? Go.
Wait.
What you here for?
How did that work out for you? Yeah.
Exactly. Call her.
That's another game night. We're gonna play.
You might well go ahead and find them. I don't know where you at, because we don't talk. So what you here for?
You said that's your husband or your wife for X amount of years or someone you just barely met. What are we talking about there, Shonda? Who are we talking about here?
They had another one that's something about 20 years, and I said, I'm going to wait for that one. But I enjoyed y'all. Thank y'all for being good sports. I love y'all so much. Ryan, go ahead and wrap us up. Wait, let me get you
my intro.
Wait, your jingle. Look at your jingle.
Yeah, real talk with Ryan David. There you go.
Talk with Ryan David. Real talk with Ryan David.
Oh, feeling it. The Holy Spirit. Yes, okay. I'll make it quick. I know our host has to get out of here. Happy birthday once again to you, Shonda. I think what I want to talk about, two things that are relative to what we talked about tonight. When we talk about relationships, we talk about self-love, and we talk about those two things together. First of all, I think that we're having such a strong issue, or such a severe issue, if you want to call it a pandemic, of individuals that are struggling with love, not just self-love, but love and relationships. We're struggling now, if you look around at people and this idea, this concept of love, and really looking for love and struggling when it comes to relationships. I think a big reason why is because people are slacking or lacking in knowing themselves first. And here's the thing about love. I think the quote from TK was great. You have to first, like I said, know who you are to know what you love. If you don't know yourself, you don't even know what you love or what to love about yourself. That's first. So you need to know yourself. Get to know yourself so you can love yourself. And you want to love yourself so that you can do exactly what we were talking about earlier, which is tell other people what it is that lights you up, that you love. Now, that's the first part that I want to point out. The second part of this that I want to point out and I want to leave you guys with is one of the biggest mistakes that people make in relationships when they go to attempt to love someone else they're in a relationship with. One of the biggest mistakes we make is we get into a relationship and we try to love the person that we're in a relationship with the way we want to be loved.
Ooh.
It is a natural tendency for us, and it is a mistake. They are not you. You know how you like to be loved, so you assume, let me love them the way I like. Let me give them what I like. Let me do what I like. They're not you. Now, common sense tells you that, of course, you know they're not you, but you'll find yourself not just, you know, you need to buy them different things than you like, but when it comes to really truly love, which is an action, you tend to act or do things in a way that you would prefer, but they don't maybe like those things. That's not their love language or what they're used to or what they consider to be love. So the biggest thing you should be cognizant of in your relationship is, first of all, am I attempting to love them the way I like to be loved? And then two, have I been clear or am I communicating with them what it is that I like or love and what they can do for me to feel loved, and also ask them what's going on with them or pay attention even to what's going on with them and what do they like or consider to be love. Those things require effort. And that's why a lot of relationships don't last, man. It really requires effort. Yeah. And you don't even have to use the word work. You know, people say, oh, relationships are hard work. They're hard work. Sure, they work, but just use the word effort, because they're amazing. They're not hard work. Like, I hate this. I got to get through it and work on this. It's effort. But when you put that effort into your relationship, the dividends that pay off, man, they're exponential. So yeah, it's effort, but the effort is to invest in things that are going to be exponentially greater once you do invest in each other. So be careful that you don't love other people the way you want to be loved. Pay attention, communicate. That's why I was stressing what we were talking about earlier. That's such a huge word in relationships. That's a foundation. As I talked about, I think last week, I talked about that. Communicate what you like, what you enjoy, what it is to be loved for you, and find out what it is to be loved for them. And you have to make those investments in the emotional bank account, which I can get into at in another episode and talk about what that means. But you've got to love them the way they like to be loved, or else no matter what your intentions are, you have good intentions to love them. But if you love them in the wrong way or in a way they don't perceive to be loved, they're not going to feel loved, and you're going to be frustrated, and it's going to be a problem. So just leave you with that little nugget for the day. I went like a minute over.
Absolutely.
Always dropping the mic.
Always taking us to class. Do I get a degree or diploma after this?
Honorary. All of y'all get an honorary degree. I don't know. Who am I to give out degrees? I'm just me.
Expand on that a little bit. I would like to say, I think we talked about it before, but we talked about love languages. You said it a couple of times. We have to make sure we're loving them how they want to be loved. And that was the second part of our question. How do you teach people how to love you? How do you show them? So that's my last question for everybody. How do you show people how to treat you? I'll answer first and then y'all can go ahead. Mm-hmm. I simply communicate. If I don't like how it feels, and I don't like how it makes me feel, I tell them. I say something because pouting and silent treatments are not going to get you loved the way you want to be loved. Absolutely. You have to have those difficult conversations, because some people will take it like, oh, you don't like me, or I'm not doing this right. You don't want to be with me. That's not what I'm saying. Mm-hmm. I want to be with you. But if we're going to be together, this is what has to happen. Yeah, right. And if I'm not loving you how you want to be loved, and I'm talking about friendships as well. Mm-hmm. If we're not going to treat each other how we want to be treated, don't treat me how you treat you. Treat me how I want to be treated. Yeah. Because that's the only way we're going to be in a friendship. I love being loved and appreciated. I love all my sisters who have shown me love, you know, just because it's my birthday. I had a good time Saturday with TK. She was, y'all don't know, TK been in that place 100 times. People know her by the left. But anyway, that's the whole thing.
They know me when I walk in.
It really made it her business, make me feel like, you know, a queen that day. You know what I mean? And I really appreciated that. And I went out to dinner with another friend the night before. Mm-hmm. And just when you teach people how to treat you, they will either take heed or they will not do it. If they don't do it, it's up to you to decide, okay, this is not working for me.
And one thing about her birthday, I want the person, it's her birthday. Not let me take you where, what's my favorite restaurant? Right. I asked her, what do you want to do, Shonda? Where do you want to go? I literally wanted to make her happy that day. Of course, she was like, I want to go to your favorite spot. So that was the only reason why we went there. But absolutely. I'm just a big communicator. As a matter of fact, next month it'll be 5 years that I've been married, and you can imagine, marriage isn't easy, but it can be, and it's done by communication. Yep. And we had to learn that the hard way. You're talking about two stubborn people who got an ego, and we will play that silent game in a minute, but it doesn't get us anywhere. Right. So we found a way. To maybe not talk at that particular moment, but later on, I could always tell him how he made me feel.
Yeah.
And then he does the same thing in his way. Like you said, Ryan, we're all different. But Ryan, that is one thing that I learned in my relationship. I was loving my husband the way that I wanted to be loved. And one day he caught me off guard, Ryan, and actually said, did you ever ask me what I wanted?
That. Yeah.
And it hit me. it hit me to the point that I was like, wow. Like,
because your intentions were good. Your intentions were good. So you're kind of offended. It's like, wait, but I'm trying. Right. But it doesn't matter what your intentions are.
Yeah. Oh, my God. You sound just like him. Get off my phone. But that's exactly what he said. Here I was trying so hard. And not that it didn't mean anything, but I was trying so hard. And he was like, you don't have to try hard. Right. Just ask me. Yeah. So that I will share that is love the person the way they ask them.
Yeah.
What do you like? So I'll pass it down to you, Ryan.
Yeah, you can't answer this question without talking about communication. You just cannot answer this question. It just comes down to that. You have to get to know what's going on with that person, and you have to be able to communicate. And so many people are poor communicators. They default to just doing what they like for the other person without finding out, and that's the mistake. Yeah. So you can't default to what you love. If you really want to fill them up, you have to find out what fills them up. And so for me, I think what I do is I'm clear about what I want, what my values are, what matters to me, what's important to me, what I enjoy, what do I love for me. I'm clear about that for myself, and then I'll communicate that, but also lead by example. I'll show them. I'll let them know what I'm doing that I enjoy, that I love. So, you know, I'll model that behavior for them to see. Well, he really likes it, or he really loves that, or this lights him up, or look how he is in that moment, or he likes that. So I'm modeling the behavior, I'm modeling the things that I like, that I enjoy, so they can see what they are. But just communicate and show and say, this is why I like this. This is what I like. Yeah. That's really what it comes down to. But you have to be clear about it first, or you're going to be lost and confused and not really know what to do.
The bells, can you wrap it up for us?
Well, honestly, I agree with everybody. I just will say that I treat my friendships like a relationship.
It is.
So without the sex, of course, but my friendship,
I feel you.
I just like my relationship. And that's why I take it so personal, because I'm never going to do that to you. I don't expect you to do it to me. But at the same time, sometimes we see signs, and just like we see red flags with relationships, we have, it's red flags in friendships. And sometimes we ignore those too. So it's just being mindful of ourselves, because I feel like, like Ryan said, communication is big, but my mom always told me it's never what you say, it's how you say it.
Mm. I taught that lesson today. It's called parallel.
That's a whole other episode, Chad. Yep.
The phone is what can make or break anything. With
tired.
That's it.
Go ahead. You heard me, MPK.
I wholeheartedly agree. Communication is key. And then I think you just got to accept the person, accept people for who they are. Even in relationships, I don't, it's not going to be perfect. Every relationship is not perfect. And you know, what's the standard for perfection? So, you know, everybody, the person that you with may not have, you know, they're going to have something that you don't like, or that you're not, you know, that's not the way that you like to do things, or they'll do something that you don't like. But you just got to weigh it. Everything has a weight. And I don't think that perfection is reachable. You just, you know, just love, and as hard as you can, love them the way that they want to be loved, and try to get it in return. But communication is definitely key.
I think the two people in the relationship set the standard that you all consider perfection. That's our standard. Both of us have the same standards. We're shooting for that. Absolutely. It's best you can do.
I want to thank you all so much. It was a great episode. I hope I'm gonna get the business, y'all, when we get offline. She gonna read me for something, but I think it was a good show. Right, the band said it was a good show, so I won't get
it. No, we enjoyed it. It was perfect.
Thank you, man.
also want to promote the Bell. They are entrepreneurs. They have a 360 camera.
Yes.
Business. That is their information at the bottom of the screen. ABC or ABCAM 360 305-332-2252. ABCAM360@gmail.com.
Yes.
They are on social media, on Facebook and on
Instagram.
So they are on there. Y'all make sure y'all please. They're always busy now. They're busy on the 25th. They with me on the 25th, well, the beginning part. So I'm trying to call them and book them right now, because I got them. Can I have an applause one more time?
Of course,
There it is. Wait, for her birthday, really?
Of course. Happy birthday. Shout out to everybody in the chat. Look at all the engagement, man. Look at all the likes, 30 likes.
Look at all the likes.
Engagement today. Shout out to everybody watching, everybody listening.
If our nephews He's 6 months today, Jordan.
Yes, Jordan.
Katrina and Ryan. That's your godson, my nephew. Thank you.
That's my godbaby, and pretty soon I'm gonna be able to give him all the kisses that I have. I cannot
wait. Made you the godmama?
I did, and they accept it. So stay out of business. Since she's been pregnant, I've been the godmama.
Who made her the godmama?
Do we need to go back some more episodes where she said godmama Shonda?
Katrina confirmed. Confirm if she's the godmama.
Please come in here and tell them that Shonda is Ryan.
Yes,
baby daddy, tell them that I'm the godmama, please.
Oh, that's right. Another Ryan. Different
messing
Ryan.
Up stuff, trying to mess up things. So I want to thank you all for tuning in. Let me find my little thing. You can find us on Talk Miami Talk Show on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter. Subscribe to our YouTube channel at Talk Miami Talk Show. Talk Miami Podcast is on Spotify.
You got your glasses on today, Shonda. What's going on, man? Ain't no excuse.
She's ready to go to her birthday dinner.
Spotify, iHeart, listen on Apple Podcasts and Google Podcasts at Talk Miami Talk Show. Do y'all have anything else to say? It was a great night. I had a good time. I hope y'all did too.
Thank you all. Thank you for subscribers and stuff.
Y'all make sure y'all go follow Bell on Brittany and Adrian. What is your YouTube page?
Adrian and Brittany Bell, just like that.
And I need all of Adrian and Brittany Bell's YouTube followers to come follow Talk Miami Talk Show and Ryan Davis to YouTube page, and also Cindy Winters' YouTube page. I don't have a YouTube page, but I ain't that famous yet.
Yeah, Ryan, someone was asking about your YouTube on here.
Everything's at the Ryan David. Everything is at the Ryan David. Google at the Ryan David. They'll find it all. Thank you.
Awesome.
Okay, good. All right. Well, I love y'all. See you don't want to be you.
All right, ladies.
Bye, everybody.
Have a good night.
Good night. Bye.
Oh, I was clapping. Good night, y'all.
There it is. All right.
Y'all. Thank you.
We'll see you guys next Monday. Enjoy your night. Bye, Adrian and Brittany.